How's it going, everybody? Welcome back. And today I'm going to show you guys how you can download, install, and use Surfshark. All the basic stuff and also explain all the features that you get with Surfshark. So before we begin, if you guys are interested in Surfshark, you'll find links to pricing and discounts in the description down below, as well as a full review if you'd like to learn more about the privacy policy, speed streaming, and torrenting capabilities, as well as security features of Surfshark. Though I will be explaining all the security features here and what they do. So, of course, when you're trying to download Surfshark on iOS or Android, all you have to do is go to your Google Play Store or Apple Store and just simply look up Surfshark and click download, and it will be right there. But let's say you're on Surfshark, the desktop version of Surfshark, you're trying to get that. Just get Surfshark, subscribe, or you can even download the application before subscribing. So all you need to do, I'm just going to go back here before I click the download and go all the way down. Okay, and you'll see VPN download. Click that, and once you click that, you'll be able to find the link here depending on the device you're trying to get it for. Let's say you're trying to get it for Windows, click the Windows icon right here, and you can download the application. Once it's downloaded, you will get a user interface that looks like this. Here's what it looks like. I'm just going to disconnect, and here's what it looks like. So it's a very simple VPN to use. It's super easy. You can just click connect and there you go. But I want to explain a little bit more about the VPN. Now, I'll stick to the VPN stuff. There are additional features here that you get if you pay a little bit of extra, but I'll stick to the VPN here since we're talking about the VPN capabilities. So you have over 3,200 servers in 65 countries. Plenty of servers all over the place. You'll find something near you no matter what. And if you are trying to secure a few more devices, not just a single device, you'll be happy to know that you can secure an unlimited number of devices with just a single subscription with Surfshark, making it a great choice for large households, or if you just want the freedom to secure an unlimited number of devices. Okay, now I like this feature right here where you can star these servers for your favorite servers, and you'll find them all in your favorites here. So I can just star, for example, I use the San Francisco server at all times, let's say, for the sake of the example, you'll find it right here. So it's a pretty cool feature. You have static IP, which will give you the same IP address if you return to these servers. So main 3 will always have the same IP address. Main 5 will always have the same IP address, unlike the regular servers, which have dynamic IP addresses. So if I connect to Albania and then disconnect and then connect again, I'll get 2 different IP addresses. So that's called a dynamic IP as opposed to the static IP. Multihop will route your connection to 2 servers rather than 1 for double the encryption. It's very self-explanatory. And if we go to the settings here, you'll find the VPN settings. Of course, there are display settings, app settings, dark mode, whatever it is. These are just preferential. So yeah, you can just mess with that on your own. But the VPN settings themselves, just to explain them a little bit, you have clean web, which is the ad blocker. There's nothing wrong with keeping that on at all times. The kill switch will stop your internet connection if the VPN disconnects unexpectedly, which will prevent any leaks from getting out of your device, which is a very useful feature, especially if you're in a censorship heavy country. WireGuard protocol is definitely the protocol that you want to use at all times, though automatic works 100% of the times because it will just adapt based on your connection and server you're connecting to. And you have Bypasser, which is known as split tunneling, which will let you choose which applications are routed through VPN and which applications can bypass the VPN tunnel. Now, this is a very useful feature. Let's say I want the entirety of my connection to be using the VPN, except for selected applications such as Steam or Tekken or whatever it is, depending on your needs, or vice versa, where you can have selected applications use the VPN while the rest of your connection is routed through the conventional or regular network. Okay, so let's just go back here, and you have a couple, of course, you have a speed test, which will save you the time of testing out these servers manually. So it'll give you the best upspeed, download speed, and latency depending on your location. And one thing actually to note is that you can even find out which servers are virtual and which servers are physical. So this is really cool. I just love that feature. I tend to like to go with physical servers basically because they are typically Physical servers are typically owned by the VPN provider as opposed to virtual servers. Okay, so a rotating IP address and no borders mode will help you if you're in a censorship-heavy country. No borders mode will bypass the censorship firewall, such as the Great Firewall of China. And rotating IP will rotate your IP address while your VPN location stays the same, which will help cover up your tracks. Now that you know what this VPN is all about and how to use it, what these features are all about, let's say you're trying to unblock the US Netflix. All you need to do is find a US server here. So one of these servers, you know, I tend to go with the New York server. So that's why I have it on my recently used. I was already connected to the US server, which is why it shows that I'm in New York here, New York server. So for the sake of the example here, let's just connect to the Dallas server and see what happens. This is just the IP finder, which will help me confirm that I am indeed connected to the server that I chose. And there we go. Now all I have to do is just refresh and check. And I am in Dallas, Texas, as far as Google Chrome or my network or my ISP is concerned. So it's really as simple as that. Again, if you guys are interested in Surfshark, you'll find links to pricing and discounts in the description down below, as well as a full review if you'd like to learn more about Surfshark. And of course, keep in mind that Surfshark does have a 30-day money-back guarantee on all of its plans, no matter which plan you decide to get. And you have live chat support to help you with a refund or anything else that you might need help with. They're very friendly and they'll help you all the way through. So that's pretty much it for this video. Comment below if you have any questions. I'll be happy to answer all of them. Like and subscribe if you'd like to support the channel and stay up to date with everything VPNs and cybersecurity. Thank you guys very much for watching. I'll see you in the next one. Have a wonderful day.